rate because I'm just so tired of having to do it over and over again. And at the time, I cannot do anything to increase the quality of this video like I can my later ones, which I already have increased quality of, because I'm awesome like that. So there. Plus, you know, Prince Boo helped me with that, with the whole Audacity thing. And then I found out, oh, Pinnacle has a sound buffer, which removes a staticky background. So, I'm going to try and improve the quality of the actual commentary audio by using Pinnacle Studio, but otherwise the actual, like, commentary itself is going to be shitty because I just am totally exasperated by this 45 minutes and 33 seconds and 12 milliseconds stretch of video that you are watching between episodes 4 and 7.5. Yes, there will be a 7.5 because that's how long the videos actually are, to the point where there will be a 7.5. Oh gosh, kill me now, Jesus Lord Almighty. Anyway, let me show you how to use this fishing harpoon. Okay, it's really, really, really simple. I didn't ever realize this at first either. And, you know, I was like, wow, what the hell is a fishing harpoon for? Why can't I just kill the fish? These things are mollids. They're under the fish general species list, like sharks and jellyfish and other stuff. But after you weaken them a little bit, you just use the harpoon and they become carvable, which is really awesome because I need two things from these guys. I need big fins and, ouch, and I need life crystals. But just in case you don't get, you need three big fins. So, in order to get big fins after this, you need to go into Area 10 in Hoga Woods during normal hunting times and just kind of kill the tuna that appear there. They look like flocks of fish, but you can actually attack them and stuff. They won't run away like the normal flocks. So yeah. Anyway, I was really, really hoping to get a life crystal from this guy, but instead I got raw meat. What the fuck? So let's just go into Area 12 now and mine since I'm here. So I want to get some malachite. I was trying to see if that was something, and it wasn't. It was just a rock. I was like, oh, it's a rock. Arr. But anyway, yeah, let's go up here. Watch my character swim. Raw, swim like a fish. Fly like a bird. Fall like a tree. Wait a moment. Anyway. Yeah, and also, I thought excite shrooms were supposed to give you, like, for an extended period of time, unlimited stamina, but I thought I was, you know, I thought wrong apparently. So I'm gonna now cook some meat in front of you because that's how boring I am for this season. This little episode series list thing. I'm just going to cook fucking meat in front of you and show you how to get a well done steak again. Watch the color of the bone. Watch it. I'll be able to guess it. I'll be able to guess it as soon as the song is done. Now, there you go, look at that, I'm doing post commentary and I'm just guessing at this, watch my amazing skills again. Never cook inside a monster, by the way, because then you can't see it, so you can be all like, now, like that. See, if you get inside a monster, you can't see the bone or anything, so you can't guess and be like, now, so yeah. Also binoculars, because I saw something buzzing around. And they're binobras! Look at my character all ducked down, it's pretty awesome. Will say, love it when my character ducks down. Why? Because she's all like, sneaker. Yeah, so I'm basically just trying to kill these guys, because they're sucky little douchebags. And, you must realize, binobras are the most annoying monsters in the game. No matter what anyone says. You want to kill them as fast as possible. Why? Because they will attack you while you try to carve a monster, stopping you from carving a monster. What else will they do? They will poison you, they will stun you, they will... Oh, I don't think they stun you actually, but they will just about annoy the hell out of you in every sense of the word. Because they are literally insects, and that is what they are there to do. Be insects and annoy the hell out of you. So I kick him, and I am like, I hate you, bug. And he swoops down behind me, and is all like, rawr. So yeah. Also, when you saw me trying to look through bones earlier, I'm trying to look for a bone called a mystery bone. I need three of them to get the blessing jewel. which will increase my whim. So that means my pickaxes, bug nets, and fishing harpoons have even less of a likely chance to break with when I use them with this armor, which is really handy. And right now, when I saw these guys fly behind me, I was like, wow, what the fuck? Because I did not know they could appear. I thought after that, first little horde, that they could not, like, there could not be any more, but I suppose I was wrong. So, yeah. Also, you can get a 1-star rare commodity for killing enough of these guys here in the Hoga Woods. You know, so it's like, whenever you see, like, Banahabra breeding or something, just, like, start going at it with these guys to get that 1-star commodity before the Argosy comes along. Yeah, so now we're mining. We got some Aqua Glow jewels and everything. That's what we needed. Getting everything we needed in Malachite, where we really want that. This is, in my opinion, the best place to get that, because you get so much of it. And once we increase the gathering ability from our armor and the whim, it'll be even easier. Just, I'm telling you guys. It's just, all of it just becomes so much easier. So yeah, now we have to talk to everyone, because it seems like everyone's all like, oh, look, you're back. You're an experienced hunter now, I suppose, because you know how to play the game. Aww. So yeah, and now we can make the hunter's mail, so we're gonna make that. And I equip it for some unknown forsaken reason. But anyway, we're gonna be making every single part of the hunter's armor except for the helmet and the frauds, because you need ice crystals for that. And you can't find those until you go to the tundra way later in the game. So I'm like, wow, what the fuck? So I decided to just buy those two pieces so that way I can have the complete set and do what I need to do with my armor. Put everything else we make, because that's the cheaper way to go, and that's good for me. So yeah, I was also looking up what perception does. It gives you Capture Guru, which basically makes your traps more effective. So yeah, and I was like, oh, I really don't need that, so yeah. And then I look at the Gathering Jewels. No! Gathering Jewel! Look at it! Don't be as dumb as me. Just go away, me. Go away. Okay, there we go. I look at the gathering jewels and I realize I need two of them. Oh, cuz. Because it would only give me plus 14 otherwise, and I don't have enough money to make two of them now, so I talked to this chick, and now basically it's what I told you before. She sells the hunter gear, which is pretty damn awesome, but it's 1,000 zenny gold, whatever, for each piece. So that's why we're gonna make 3 out of the 5 pieces. Yay! And here's the equipment manager. Yeah. So now we equip the leather vest back on, and we're gonna move everything around, because that's how we roll. We like to move things around. And let's move that thing right there. Okay. Yeah, so it's pretty straightforward from here on out. I mean, there's only like a few minutes left anyways. Just gonna deposit all my crap and blah 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 blah. I'm actually gonna put a stop to it here. Next time you see me, I'll have hunter's armor and everything I need to go on with the game. So I'll see you guys then. Until then, this is AngelusCoheed signing out. Oh yeah, by the way, golden fish bait, make some. See you then. Bye bye.